Okay, let's talk now about basic HTML elements. I have opened up the starter kit files in VS Code. I also have the live server running over here so I can make changes and we can see them quickly. What we're looking at here in the HTML file is HTML or hypertext markup language instructions that the browser uses to decide what to do with the text and other elements that are inside this file, how to render them out for the viewer to see and use. So each one of these elements that starts with a pointy bracket and then some instruction and a closed pointy bracket, each of these is a tag in HTML. And most of them have, as you see here in VS Code, a starting and an ending point. The only difference is, say in the case of this head instruction, the ending one has a slash right after the first pointy bracket. So together, this defines one HTML block or one HTML instruction with other information inside of it. We have a similar thing here with the body. So we have a opening body tag and a closing body tag, and then some things inside of it that the browser is going to render. Each of these three major blocks defines a different part of the information that your web page is providing to the browser. This first part, which is almost the entire file, is the HTML opening and then closing tag. And everything in between there is the HTML information that the browser is going to use to render your page. There is a doc type tag up here. This is a special tag. It should be the first on the first line of an HTML file, and that just tells the browser that everything below is an HTML format so that it knows how to make sense of things like head and H1 and things like that. Inside of each one of these lower level tags, such as head and body, are information provided to the browser to set up and configure or to actually display information on the page. The head block provides metadata for the browser to use to know how to render and create the information from your page. And the body section here contains all of the information that should be rendered out on the page. So while we have three elements here inside a head, we don't see any of them here. We do, however, see the results of them, such as title here. We have this text, and that text appears up here in the tab for the page that I'm on. The character set helps the browser decide how to render pages for different languages. And then finally, this style sheet link is what is telling the browser some of the style information, which we'll talk about in another video. One of the things it's doing is causing the background to be this light blue. Now, the body contains, like I said, the information to be rendered. So we see an H1 or a header 1 here with some text, and we see that information appear on the screen. If I add a, let's say, an H3, and when I save that, that gets rendered out, and we see that, of course, smaller, but also rendered in the order that it appears in the body. If I were to rearrange these and save, you'll see that they switch on the browser. So, order inside of each one of these tags is important. However, the information that you're going to display on the screen needs to be inside this body segment. If we put it up here in head, it wouldn't do anything. Or it actually may do something kind of unexpected. And I say unexpected because it's going to be up to the browser to decide how to handle something that's in the wrong place. So let's talk about the browser for a minute. There are several modern browsers. There are browsers that are updated regularly and keep up with all the standards of HTML, CSS, and other web technologies so that they can be used for us to find and access information on the internet. The browser comes with information to take a standard HTML file, such as we have here, and turn it into something that's a little more visually appealing, a little bit easier to read for the viewer of that web page. So it knows what to do with a head and a closing head tag and how to react to the things inside. It knows what an H3 and an H1 is. It knows how to render all the stuff inside the body. However, without supplying any other information, the browser gets to decide just how big an H1 is. So I don't specify here in the H1 tag any information about how big, nor do I do that for the H3 tag. The browser is deciding on its own. It has some built-in settings. So when it sees an H1, it's going to make the text this big, however big these characters are, whatever font that it selected. This was all done by the browser, and each browser can be a little bit different. So without providing any other information in the HTML or CSS file, web pages may look slightly different. However, because modern web browsers adhere to some standards for HTML, an H1 is always going to be larger than an H3. Now, I don't know how much larger, but if the browser is current, up to date, and following the HTML5 standards, an H1 is always going to be bigger than an H3. So it still follows the standard, but beyond an H3 being smaller, the browser gets to decide how much smaller or what font or even what color. So keep that in mind as you're working on your assignments in this class. If you see something in a certain format and it's not how you described it, there may be something wrong, and what you're seeing is not your text color or your font style. It may just be the browser not understanding the information you provided, and so it just falls back to a default to at least generate the information. So let's talk a little bit about some standard HTML elements or tags that you're going to be using here in the body for your assignments. This is not all of them you'll be using, but it is the basic ones that you'll be using in all of your assignments. So the first one is headings, which we see a couple here. I'm going to remove these headings, and I'm just going to put in a sample of all of them. I'm going to cheat and copy from someplace else and paste them in. But what I've created is an H1, an H2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. These are all the header sizes that HTML follows and that the browser should be able to render. They're in order. So as soon as I save, we should see this disappear, see this new text appear in various sizes. So let's save that. There we go. So we can see H6 is pretty small compared, it's very small compared to H1. And so we can see what the browser decided to do here as far as size, alignment, color, all of that stuff. All those defaults are kicking in here, and the browser is deciding all of those things for me because I've not provided any information. We will later, but for right now, we're just using the browser's defaults. So the purpose of headings is to create some information that summarizes the information the viewer is going to see when they read your web page. So this is like a title at the top of a document, or maybe in a part of a document where you're describing something new, you're going to have a header of maybe of different sizes because you've got a title for your paper, and then maybe you have a section. So that size would be a little bit smaller and a lot of information in the section. Maybe you'll have another H2 for another section, but each one of these is going to be a title or a subtitle of the information. In this case, on your web page, and you get to decide as you're building up your information which headings you want to use to organize your information on the page. Now I'm going to clean this up a little bit and make it look probably more like an actual web page might. I'm going to duplicate this. So I'm going to have two headings, and I'm going to rename this to title, and we'll call this one section 1 and section 2. Okay, so save that. So now I have the start of this page that I'm going to create. So with the titles in place, now I know the overall organization. So now I'm going to put in a paragraph, another HTML element, and the P tag, or the paragraph tag, is where you put the bulk of the content that the user is here to read. Now I'm going to use the lorem ipsum trick here to put in some text. And in this paragraph, I will put 25 words, hit tab, and now that's populated with a paragraph. Second paragraph here. And I'm going to add a 50 word lorem ipsum. And I now have two paragraphs inside of my body underneath the H2 tag. Now, one thing to keep in mind in your HTML file is the browser doesn't really worry too much about extra spaces you might have in your file. So this is a little bit hard to read. So I can actually add some extra spaces in here without changing how it's going to end up out here on the browser. When the browser loads this up, it's not going to care about this blank line. So when I save, we still see things here. I can put a whole bunch of blank lines and save, and the browser ignores them all. It doesn't matter. So feel free when you're editing your file to add some blank lines just to make it easier to read. Not a lot of blank lines, because it can make it harder to read as your file gets larger. But at this point, I've got my section 1 here. I think I'm going to copy and paste, and I'll put a little blank line in there, save that. And so now my two sections have a couple of paragraphs each in them. So far, the tags that we've been using have both an opening and a closing part. Same thing with the paragraph. You can see the P and then the slash P. One nice thing that VS Code does is when you double click and highlight one of them, it shows you the other one. And so you can kind of see where the start and end is if your page is getting a little crowded. I can make this a little bit bigger and hopefully make it easier to see. So there's another tag that I might want to add to my page. I'm going to create a little space here, and it is the horizontal rule, or HR tag. Now this tag does not have an ending part, because it just does one thing and it doesn't take any information to do that. It just draws a line between the stuff above and the stuff below. So you watch right here between this section 2 and the paragraph when I save, and we see a line appear. So this just visually separates these two sections. I guess if I wanted to be consistent, I can even add another one here and make it look kind of similar. Probably want to put one at the bottom too for symmetry, I guess. But I can add those in just to create a blank line and just a little more space, change the way that my document looks. There we go. So nice and even. So now I've got this basic document with some of the standard HTML tags that we're going to be using, the header, H1, H2, and other header sizes, horizontal rule, and the paragraph tags. All of these are going to be present in all of the assignments that you do in CS 102.